Well, today's episode, we're only going to feature two reviews here. First one's going to be the semifinals of the G1 Climax. As you know, we already announced who will be representing the four blocks. But also, we'll determine who will be facing in the finals later on the following day. We also got AEW Dynamite House of the Dragons, which is going to feature a lot of good matches. As you know, we got the best two out of three falls. We got, of course, Tony Storm in action. We also got the first start of the AEW Trios Tag Team Tournament that's taking place in our main event. And, of course, a couple of news updates that I'm willing to share what's been going on in the world of pro wrestling. So, let's get ready for another episode of Deleted Wrestle Zone. Welcome everybody to the Deleted Wrestle Zone, all things that is pro wrestling with AEW, NXT, New Japan Pro Wrestling, Impact Wrestling, the National Wrestling Alliance, various promotions, wrestlers, matches, and championships. I am your host, Gerard here. So, let's begin with our first match in the G1. As you know, our main events will be, our co-main events actually, is the semifinals. But let's see what took place throughout the entire time of this entire match. First up, we have Chaos, consistent of Yo, Yoshihashi, Tomohiro Ishin, Goto to take on the members of Suzuki Gun. That consists of Taka Michinoku, Doiki, Kanemaru, and Lance Archer. Now, this is a very interesting matchup because, as you know, there's no storyline built. But, as you know, the only people involved in championship is Yo, Yoshihashi, and Hiroki Goto. But it was Yo who picked up the victory by pinning Taka Michinoku. Next up, we have Team Filthy, Royce Isaacs and Tom Lawler, to take on the other members of Suzuki Gun. We have, Dangerous Techers, Taichi and Zack Sabre Jr. Now, keep in mind, I like the dynamics of this particular matchup because if you look, they're almost similar. You have Tom Lawler, who is a submission specialist, MMA background. You got also the same thing with Zack Sabre Jr. But however, in this particular match, it was the armbar that set up the real difference by Zack Sabre Jr. onto Royce Isaacs, because he was able to get out of it, so he had no other choice but to tap out. Next up, we got TMDK, consistent of Bat, Dude, Tito, and Jonah, taking on Great Bash Shield, GBH, Tomo Akihamna, and Toki Makabe. Now, this is a very unique match because, you know, there is the possibility, there has been rumors about circulating that maybe Bad Dude Tito and Jonah could return to Japan for World Tag League, which is something we know it could happen later on this year. But it's still not official yet. We know it could happen. But it was, of course, Jonah who picked up the victory by pinning Hamna in this one. Next up, we got the members of the Bullet Club, consistent of Chase Owens, Balak Fale, and Juice Robinson, to take on the members of the United Empire, consistent of Aaron Henare, Grid O'Conn, and Jeff Cobb. Now, as you know, Bullet Club and United Empire has been at each other's throats for quite some time. United Empire has always claimed that, you know, Bullet Club is a thing of the past. It's time for the world to forget about them, but Bullet Club has been making some headways ever since the Catalyst made some major moves in the group. But I don't see anything happen. I don't think that the wishes of the United Empire is going to come true. But it was, of course, the package pile driver by Chase Owen onto Jeff Cobb that sealed the deal. Onto Hanare that sealed the deal. So, basically. But, however, there is the talk that there is a chance that we could see Chase Owens and Balak Fali once again pursue the IWGP World Heavyweight Tag Team titles that are currently being in the possession of FTR. Next up, we got the other members of Bullet Club, LTP, Yujiro Takahashi, Kenta, and Evil, along with Togo and Sho, to take on all four members of LIJ, Bushi, Hiromu Takahashi, Sanada, and of course Shingo Takagi. This match ended in a very brutal way as possible. It was Kenta's lapel lock to seal the deal onto Sanada. On Bushi, because Bushi is one of the most weakest link of the group, which is okay. He is a former IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion, but that's how it has always been. Next up, we got Kushida, David Finley, Yano, and Tanahashi to take on the members of Bullet Club's Taiji Shimuri, Doc Gallows, Carl Anderson, and Jay White. Now, you probably guessed that this match was really crazy, but the one thing that was very interesting is Yano. He did not participate much in the match, but he took matters in his own hands when, of course, my monitor went out, took out low blow to, of course, Doc Gallows. They gave, of course, the win to his team, and that pretty much it. But in the back, Doc Gallows was not happy with the results. Now let's get to our semifinals between A and B. We have Tama Tonga and Kazuchika Okada. I have to say, what a match. I loved it. It was like, unbelievably, this is the first time we see this, but I have to say, I think I was rooting for Tama because I feel Tama should be at the top right now, but he lost the match thanks to the Rainmaker. But he did mention in the post comments that he doesn't consider this as a loss. He considers like maybe a gain. This is the first time he's ever gone this far in the G1 in his entire time as a member of Bullet Club. I feel now that without Bullet Club, it gave him a much better perspective. And he mentioned that ever since he got kicked out, it's like his identity was taken. But now he's back to the Tama Tonga from almost 10, 12 years ago that he remembers. That eager kid that he remembered that he was. So that's going to set some better standards for Tama Tonga. Now our main event, we have Tetsuya Naito and Will Ospreay for the first time ever. I thought this match was great. A little bit of the calculated moves, but it was, of course, Will Ospreay that set up the Stormbreaker to win the match in order for him to win. He's going to be facing in the finals a man that he's never beaten before, but he knows he can beat him if he believes himself, even though he claims that everybody has doubted him, because he knows there are people that have beaten him before, like Kenny Omega. Tanahashi and various others. So he thinks like, you guys were able to beat him, so can I. So that kind of tells us that story. But we'll see what happens then. So we will see in the finals Okada and Will Ospreay once again face off. So I think that's pretty much it right now with the New Japan G1 stuff. I believe it's time for AEW Dynamite House of the Dragons. AEW Dynamite House of the Dragons. We had a very interesting promo coming up with CM Punk talking about giving Hangman Page a rematch. And then later things got a little bit heated with Jon Moxley. As you know, this is one of those matches where, okay, who's going to walk out? Who's going to be declared the true champion? How this is going to be unified? This went ballistic. So, but it did continue later on where, of course, things were getting out of hand. Even members of the Blackpool Combat Club tries to restrain Moxley, but it's already became official that we will see those two this coming Wednesday to unify both titles. So we'll see who will walk out as the winner. Now, we do get an interview with Powerhouse Hobbs. However, we've been asking ourselves, why did Hobbs did exactly what he did? So it turns out the reason, he said he had one job to do, is to protect Ricky Starks from losing the title, and that's what he did. However, he did lose the title to Hook, so it's like, you know, he failed. What am I here for? So that kind of puts it in a very interesting predicament. I don't know how Taz would react to it, but it is what it is. Now, Jericho comes out to commentary because our match is the best 2 out of 3 falls between Bryan Danielson, the American Dragon, versus the so-called Dragon Slayer. I thought the match was unbelievably violent, brutal. You probably guessed how this one is. Stomping, forearms, all of it, you can say. But it was Bryan Danielson to pick up the win with 2 falls. The first fall came, of course, was Bryan Danielson, then later Daniel Garcia, and finally Bryan Danielson was able to win by that. And of course, he was a show respect to Daniel Garcia, but later Jericho attacked him, and then of course this happened. Looks like there's dissension coming in within Jericho Appreciation Society. The obvious question is Daniel Garcia may be able to walk away from Chris Jericho? Even this is what happened during the backstage. We see Jericho trying to tell him that he will confront him in the face, but Ricky Steamboat shows up saying that, you know, that Ricky need him. But Parker actually was dumb enough to confront him, and he got his ass whooped. So that kind of tells it all. Now, we do get an interview with Swerve and Argler in Private Party. As you know, you can tell by the confidence of Swerve and Argler, both Swerve and Lee, that things will stay right where it's supposed to be, but anything could change. So they better be 100% ready for this. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Now, our next match, we have the Varsity Blondes versus, of course, the Gun Club. The match went out quickly. It gave the Gun Club the win. But, however, Billy Gunn tried to give his promo to his sons. And then all of a sudden, Stokey Hathaway shows up. And then we saw the shocking betrayal of both Austin and Colton. Looks like they aligned themselves with Stokey Hathaway. But luckily, out of the blue, we see the Acclaim coming out to make the save. And it looks like that Billy Gunn's going to stick around with the Acclaim from now on. So that's going to tell us a different story. Now, as you know, Jay Lethal has been crying about how unfair his match was with Warlow, and he demanded a rematch, which he did. But of course, he did not anticipate the arrival of FTR, which they did. And I thought it was a pretty good match in its own way. But however, we will see that a trios type match or so. But anyway, speaking of trios, we have what's her name? Dev Triangle sending a direct message to Andrade and his cohorts. So that kind of puts it in a very good perspective way. I can't wait to see how this one's going to go. Now, Jungle Boy, as you know, he's been on a world tear to get his hands on Jericho, on Christian Cage, for what he's done. And I think that kind of puts him in a predicament. He even tried to back out from it, but nothing did. So, however, apparently, Christian tried to save his own ass by saying that they don't need to fight, that he will give him like the keys to the kingdom, that sort of thing, but it did not help him whatsoever. So we will see that at All Out as soon as possible. Now, FTR comes out, talk about that they did what was right for Drew Parker, Warlow. They felt like they did the right thing. So that's kind of sets the tone on everything. But I think it tells us now that these guys, even though they didn't have to do what they did for Warlow, but you know, Warlow can trust them. So that kind of tells us that type of sentimental thing. Next up, of course, we do have Dax Harwood versus what's his name? Well, I can't pronounce the guy's name right, but yeah. So, oh. Oh yeah, we do get a now we get to our next match, which is Kylan King versus Tony Storm. I thought the match was good. It was pretty interesting. Of course, Thunder Rosa was watching, keeping an eye on this match because, you know, what's her name? Madeline says that she is the number one right now, so that kind of puts it in, but it was reverse. Eventually, this guy died. I think what I did like is Tony Storm did not give up. Kylan King, no matter how big she was able to overcome it, but she pulled it off real nicely in order to win. Of course, Thunder Rosa knows she's the number one contender. So this is going to be a very interesting thing that's going to take place. Now, our main event, we have our opening round of the Trios Championship. We have, of course, Rush, Dragon Lee, and Andrade El Idolo taking on the members of the Elite, the Bucks. And then, of course, we saw the return of Kenny Omega wearing a shirt. Now, it looks more like he's not 100%, but the match was pretty good. I think it showed a lot of character with Kenny, what he can do no matter what happens, but it was pretty amazing. But it was, of course, Kenny that picked up the win with the one win angel, I think, and 1, 2, 3, it's over. But there was a post match that took place when they tried to take out Drag Lee, thinking that it was over. But I can't wait to see what the Elite can throw in. I'm excited for this, so I think that's pretty much it. Hope everybody excited that he see Dragon Lee. But he will be returning back to his normal self. Forgot what's the name. But yeah. But I think that's pretty much it right now. I believe it's time to move on to our last thing, which is going to be news updates. Updates, I only have two of them so far. They came from Fightful Select. The first one is Taylor Wilde. Now, we were on the initial assumption as fans that Taylor Wilde was released from the company, but unfortunately, it's not exactly what we thought. She is still under contract by Impact Wrestling. However, the only reason we haven't seen her for quite some time is that she's dealing with her divorce. And it looks more like it's, how do I say, what a perfect time to make her return. I think it's pretty good. So basically, she had to be pulled from the roster for a short time, but now she is. We don't know what was the reasons and all this, but hopefully we get to see more of her what we expect. Now, our last thing, we have Jun Akiyama spoke highly about Eddie Kingston. As you know, he came from All Japan and this and that, and he understands the power of King's Road, which is something that he's familiarized with, and I think that tells us a lot. But even though he's Akiyama said that he is not a fan of watching overseas, but he's been watching recently Konosuke Takeshita and all that, so we'll see what happens then. But I'm excited for it. So that's pretty much it, what we got. I believe it's time to call it a day. Well, I hope everybody enjoys this episode. Coming up, we got more with the finals of the G1, and of course we have NXT UK and Impact Wrestling, which I'm excited to review. But for now, I'll see you guys in the next DWZ time. Same DWZ channel. I must bid all of you adieu. So, goodbye. Mwah. And have a nice day. Bang.